Okay, so punta tayo dito sa transverse reinforcement. So bali yung ginukuha natin dito is yung spacing ng lateral ties. Okay? So this applicable for actually loaded columns with shear loads. So provided meron tayo ditong section, then may shear loads na apply dito, no? Let's say ito yan. Yung VU. So may VU tayong in-apply. So the same formula with the beam. So it's just V nung nominal shear. Where yung nominal shear is just shear in concrete and shear in lateral ties. No? Yung phi dyan is just 0.85 for 2001 and for 2010 or 2015, that is just 0.75. And in terms of loading, so meron tayong, mostly naman sa problem is yung load combination natin is dead load and live load. So kung 2001, that is 1.4 and 1.7. And for 2010 or 2015, that is 1.2 and 1.6 for the dead load and live load respectively. Okay? So in solving for the VC, okay, yung pag-solve nito, meron tayong dalawang method na applied. Yung nakikita nyo dito is, this is a simplified method or approach. Okay, so mostly ito naman yung ginagamit natin. Pwede rin detailed, pero allowed man din to sa code na gamitin mo yung simplified, di ba? Especially for hand calculation. So, mas maganda yung simplified method. And for board exam, minsan, ito lang din yung ginagamit natin. So, yung simplified method is just 1 over 6 ng 1 plus nu over 14 gross area. Square root ng FC prime times B times nung effective depth. So, makikita mo yung effective depth dito sa figure. Okay? Ayan. So, yung effective depth is always parallel yung direction niya sa shear. Okay? So, tandaan niya lagi yan. So, yung NU, yan yung mga axial. Nga pala, no? Yung dito, lahat to is, lahat yan, tsaka lahat yan. Yan yung dead load, tsaka live load nung due to shear. Okay? Yung NU naman is dead load and live load due to axial load. Okay? So, axial load yung NU, yung VU is shear. So, DL shear, LL shear, DL shear, LL shear, DL axial, LL axial, DL axial, LL axial. So, ganun. So, yun yung sa simplified method. Okay? So, pagpakuha mo yung spacing, so pwede mo nang gamitin yung formula na to. The same with the formula sa shear and beams, no? Same talaga, no? And then yung spacing, if yung 1/3 nung square root nung FC prime BD that is greater than VS, use D over 2. Otherwise, kung dito ma-meet, use D over 4. So, ganun lang, no? So, I hope klaro tayo dyan. Okay, so pero yung requirements for the maximum spacing ng ties is same pa rin dun talaga sa shear and beams, no? So the same, yung nagbago lang talaga yung formula for the VC kasi applied to for actually loaded column with shear loads. Okay. So, meron din tayong simplified approach at saka detailed approach, na? So, ito yun. So, we have the allowable shear strength for simplified calculation. So, pag subject yung member natin with shear and pleasure, so, ito yung gagamitin natin na formula, which is applicable for the beam, di ba? Applicable for the beam. Pag subject to axial compression, so, yun na yun. Yung kanina yung pinakita ko. So, ito naman yung formula na gagamitin. Okay? So, meron din tayong sa detailed calculation, no? So, ganun pa rin. Kung subject yan sa shear and pleasure, so, ito yung formula na gagamitin mo. Diba? So, first is evaluate mo muna to. Pero dapat, it must be less than or equal 1. So, if yung value na to is greater than 1, so, take 1, no? So 1 yung gagamitin mo. And then yung N nyo dito is negative 4 tension. So kung tension siya, negative, pag compression, positive. So yun yung sa detailed, okay? Pag axial compression and then detailed calculation, so ito naman yung formula na gagamitin mo, where you need to evaluate first yung MN. Okay? So once makuha mo na yung value ng MN, so i-check mo yan. I-check mo yan. So if it is greater than 0, so ito na yung gagamitin mo. Okay? Tsaka ito. Okay? Pag less than yan ng 0, so ito na yung gagamitin mo. Automatic na yan. Okay? Ayan. No? Then, take note din yung VU over VUD over MU is not limited to 1. So, hindi siya, wala siyang limit. Hindi katulad nung dito sa shear and pleasure na limited siya sa 1. So, I hope klaro tayo dyan. Okay? So, pag yung MN mo, MM, pag yung MM mo is greater than 0, mag-example ito yung formula A and B. So, smaller value of A and B yung gagamitin. If yung MM mo is less than 0, so automatic na si B yung gagamitin. So yun no, kaya kailangan nating compute-in yung value ng MM. Okay? Okay. Ah, dito pala no. When MM is negative, so ito na yung gagamitin mo na formula. So I hope klaro tayo dyan. And then meron din tayong members subject to axial tension. So pag subject siya sa axial tension, so magbago yung formula. So ito naman yung gagamitin natin, no? Formula. Okay? So yung minimum area ng shear reinforcement is the same with the shear and beams. Okay? So ayan. So yun lang yung mga value nung shear, okay? So saan naman makikita yung VU? NU, VU, and MU. So, dito natin makikita yan, no? Okay? So, ito, no? Provided meron tayo ditong column. So, yan, no? Yan yung mga MU, VU, and NU. Yan. Okay? So, klarong-klaro. So, mga loadings lang yan. Mga factored loads. Sige, so yun lang guys for ano formulas nung shear in columns, okay? So mostly yung ginagamit natin is simplified, okay? Sige, sa next na video is mag-solve tayo ng problem. So i-solve lang natin to, okay? I-design natin yung spacing nung transverse reinforcement. See you in the next video.